What you're looking at is not the work of aliens. It's an infamous South Florida landmark, popular with tourists and partiers eager to leave their stamp.
Everybody in Florida pretty much knows about them.
That's our guide, Captain Andrew Border. He's taking us to the dome homes off Cape Romano, not far from Naples. And our 15-minute boat ride through the 10,000 islands feels like a magical trip back in time when the domes finally appear. When this was built, it was a millionaire's dream. A tour posted on YouTube by the builder's daughter shows it was a model of 80s glory on the beachfront about 100 feet from the water. Almost 40 years later, it's out to sea.
Just because of the land erosion, just kind of washed away that beach area. And now the domes sit out in the water about 200 feet.
There's a lot of concern about how strong these domes actually are. In Hurricane Irma, two of them actually dropped into the ocean.
After taking hits, this legendary home is slowly drowning piece by piece. It's also buried in paperwork, with the back and forth between the owner and code enforcement as frequent as the tides. Circa obtained the records that show what was left of this place was labeled dangerous as far back as 2005, listed as violating county code in 2007, and handed a $250 fine every day for 3,844 days until the case was closed in May with a nearly $1 million tab.
The state did recently take these over a couple months ago.
And a letter obtained by Circa shows the dome homes are now Florida's problem officially. The State Department of Environmental Protection says the submerged property is in an existing special aquatic preserve known for birds and wildlife.
Oh my gosh, how cool.
So who pays the fines and what happens next? The records show a move to higher ground never got permits. A 2015 effort to take the domes out to sea for an artificial reef stalled with just a couple $100 in funding. The state tells Circa DEP will make the call on fines, but first they have to figure out where the homes actually sit. Time's ticking as these oddities are left leaning in the ocean, a potential hazard to boaters and tourists.
Obviously, they can't really stand all that hurricane force sitting out in the open water like that. Just the pillars are getting deteriorated. And if we do have another good hurricane, most likely the remaining four domes will crash into the water.